my sensors indicate a new episode of Dave's Vintage Apple Tech has just been uploaded.
Hi guys, this is Dave from Dave's Vintage Apple Tech, and I just saw a video from Action Retro. He has a fantastic website. Guys, go to his site. He's got a lot of good information. I'll have links on my site. And apparently there's a method of how to install OS 10.6 Snow Leopard PowerPC Beta on a G4 or a G5 Mac. So I'm going to do it on my cube, and we'll see what happens. I'm hoping it works, and so we will give it a try. Okay, guys, so I've downloaded it from Mac Rumors, the beta version of the Snow Leopard. And so right now I'm just copying it to the desktop from my flash drive. I copied it from my Mac on a flash drive, put it in a cube, and then I'm just putting it on a desktop. And then once that is download, or once it's copied over, then we will try to install it. I deleted the 9.2.2 partition. It's only a 12 gigabyte partition. And reason why I did that one is because that's real easy to put back on if this doesn't work. And if this does work, then I will make the partitions bigger. I'll probably do a 4 partition drive so I can have all four systems on it, which would be pretty cool. So anyway, it's going to be a while. That's only a USB 1 or USB 2 stick, but really it's just a USB 1 on the cube here. So anyway, data transfer ain't that fast. So anyway, we'll be back as that copies over. Okay, be back in a few. Okay guys, so I downloaded that and I copied it over to my desktop right there, and then once it got copied over, I dragged it over here, and then I went up to images and I clicked restore image, and so that's what we're doing now. So restoring that DMG image, and then when that's done, then I will show you the next step. Okay guys, so it successfully restored the image on it. So now what we're going to do is we are going to restore it on our untitled disk here. So what we're gonna do is gonna hit restore here, and this is our destination disk, and this will be our source disk, and we want to click that because according to Action Retro, he tried to do it without doing that, and I guess this makes it a block copy, so it does a much more thorough job transferring it over. So we're going to hit restore and we'll see what happens. Guys, so it looks like it copied everything over here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click out of that, and we go to preferences here, and let me go down here, system preferences here, and then we're going to hit startup disk, and we're going to hit untitled 1, And that's going to be our startup disk. Okay. And we are going to restart it. So hopefully it will work. We will find out. It's the moment of truth to see if it'll boot into this. Snow Leopard. We are in uncharted territory. Well, that's a good sign right there. Hopefully we won't kernel panic here. So far, so good. Yes. Nice. Okay, we're in the welcome screen here. Sweet. Look at that, guys. We are into Snow Leopard now. Boy, she's still loading up here because it's a new setup. Let's let it finish. I guess there were some issues of the wireless not working, but I just got it plugged into Ethernet, so it shouldn't be a problem there. But anyway, still loading up there. There we go. Seeing everything. Let's just let this thing calm down here. It's going to be indexing the drive probably. Get all that there. And let's go to about this Mac. And looky there. 10.6. That's Snow Leopard. Sweet. All right. Very good. So, wow, this is cool. Let's see, let's try a couple things here. Volume works, good. And, okay, let's go to, and the clock's right, that's good. And let's just see if there's any software updates. They're still updating this. You know, you can still get updates for Tiger and stuff, and for Leopard. Let's see if there's anything for Snow Leopard. Software is up to date. Okay, all right. Well, there you go. So we will change this here to Stanford. All right. There we go. Sweet. All right. Nice. Okay. Hey, this has been a successful update. Now I have Tiger, I have Leopard, and now Snow Leopard. Awesome. So what I got to do is I got to put 10.4 Firefox on this. I'll put that 10.5 YouTube on it. I'll put that on there. And yeah, guys, this has been great. I am so happy that I learned this. Again, this is from Action Retro. I just happened to watch his channel. He did found this on the Mac Rumors forum. And I'm going to put links on here where you can go. And this also is supposed to work on G4s and G5s as well, which this is a G4. But yeah, I am just thrilled to death. This is awesome. I mean, I just love it when people come up with hacks and find beta versions that were hidden from us. This is just fantastic. I am so happy. So again, thank you very much, Action Retro. I'll give you a shout out here. I hope everybody checks your channel out, and I'll put a link on the video. And you guys have a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next video.